Hey guys, welcome to this video. Suppose we are asked to write a program that input the height of a triangle and display the triangle of character according to that height. So guys, let's code this program. For characters we have to declare a character variable. Let's say ch is equal to capital A. So we have to display the triangle of characters. Then we have to declare a couple of integer variables, n for height of triangle, then I j. Now we'll enter height of triangle. Height of triangle. Line. Scene. And now we have to display the height of triangle of character. For int we have declared int I already, so we will simply initialize here. I is equal to 1. Because we have already declared here. I is less than or equal to n, because we have to print the triangle according to this and height entered by the user, less than or equal to n, and then we will increment our this counter variable. Now we will use nested loop for this purpose. J is equal to 1 colon j is less than or equal to I. So our j is dependent on the value of this I. So our inner loop will be executed depending on the value of this I. Then j plus plus. So this is our inner loop. So here we will display our character. Cout ch. So this is our character variable ch. Then we will give some space, and here we will let's use slash n. It is used for next line. Both endl and slash n are used for new line. So guys, we have to let's guys execute this program. Let's say I entered 5. So see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So triangle of height 5 is printed on the console window. If we want here A, B, C, D, we can do that. How? Simply increment the value of character here. As we know, the ASCII value of capital A is 65, and here we each time the loop execute, we are incrementing the value of character. So 65 will become 66. So 66 is the ASCII value of capital B. Similarly, 67 is the ASCII value of capital C. In this way, A, B, C, D will be the triangle of capital letters will be printed like so. A, B, C, D, E, F, so. So guys, this is the simple program to print the triangle of any given length. Let's guys execute this program manually. First of all, I have declared a character variable ch, and we have assigned capital A to this variable. So ch contains capital A. Then I have declared three integer variable n for length ij for loop iteration. So I am taking input of height of triangle from the user. Let's suppose I entered 3. So the now n contains 3. Then for I is equal to 1, I contains 1. 1 is less than n contains 3. So 1 is less than 3, yes, this condition becomes 2. So the control enters the body of this outer loop. So the control comes here. Again there is a loop. So j is equal to 1, j is less than 1, I, j contains 1, I contains 1. 1 is less than 1, no, 1 is equal to 1, yes, 1 is equal to 1. So this condition becomes true. So ch contain a, so a is printed here. And then space. Then we are incrementing the value of ch plus ch. It means it will increment the ASCII value of this character. So previously ch contains capital A, the ASCII of capital A is 65. Now ch plus plus, it will increment the value by 1. So 60 ch will become 66. So now the next time B will be printed. So our loop is terminating. The control again come here. J value of J was 1. So 1 plus 1, 2. So J has become 2. So the control comes here and check the condition. 2 is less than 1 because I contains 1. No. 2 is equal to 1. No. So this condition becomes false. So the control will skip the body of this loop and comes here. And here we are starting a new loop. So our control was here. So slash n will move our pointer to the next line. So now our pointer is here. Again, this is the terminating braces of outer loop. So the control will come here and increment the value of I. So I value was previously 1, so now it has become 2, or 1 plus 1, 2. So 2 is less than 3, yes. This condition becomes true, so the control again enter here. J is equal to 1, so the value of J becomes 1. J is less than 2 because now I contains 2, yes, J is 2. 1 is less than 2, so control comes here and print here B. And again, it increment the value of CH. So CH becomes 67, which is the ASCII value of C. So C will be printed because we are printing a character variable. So again, the control comes here. The value of J becomes 2. So 2 is less than J. I contains 2. J contains 2. 2 is less than 2. No. 2 is equal to 2. Yes. This condition becomes true. So the again C out CH. So C is printed. Again, this the value of CH is incremented and control comes here. Value of J becomes 3. 3 is less than 2. No. So the condition becomes false. So our control will skip the body of this inner loop and comes here, and our control will move to the next line. Due to this slash n, it is used for new line. So our control will shift here. Our pointer will shift here in the start of third line. Now again, this is the closing braces of our outer loop. So the control will again shift here, increment the value of I, which was previously 2. So 2 plus 1, I becomes 3. Again, check the condition. I 2 is less than I has become 3. So 3 is less than 2. 3 is less than 3. No. 3 is equal to 3 because n contains 3. and I contains 3. 3 is less than 3? No. 3 is equal to 3? Yes. So the condition becomes 2. So the control again enter here, and j is equal to 1. So j becomes 1. J 1 is less than 3 because I contains 3. Yes. So d is printed here, and again this increments the value of ch. So the next character will be printed. So again the control will come here. The value of j becomes 2. 2 is less than 3. Yes. Again e is printed here, and again we are increment the value of ch, so that next character will be printed. So the value of j becomes 3. 3 is less than 3. No. 3 is equal to 3. Yes. So again ch is printed. So what is the value of ch? F is printed. So again we are increment the in this character, and a control will again shift here. J becomes 3 plus 1, 4. 4 is less than 3. No. 4 is equal to 3. No. So that this condition becomes false. So the control will skip the body of this inner loop and directly jump here. So here we are starting a new line though. So the our pointer will be moved to the next line here. And so again closing braces of outer loop. So the control will jump here. Value of I, which was previously 3, now 3 plus 1 become 4. So I becomes 4. So 4 is less than 3. No. 4 is equal to 3. No. So the outer condition becomes false. So the control will skip the body of this outer loop and directly jump down here, and our program terminates. So in this way we can print the triangle of any given length. Okay guys, this is it for this video. Please don't forget to subscribe programming languages. If you have any query, you can ask. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.